Welcome back, folks. My name is Mead, and you're watching Forgecraft. Today, we're going to do some more ChristmasCraft stuff. We're actually going to make some of the things, and I'll show you some of the stuff that that you can do with it. One thing I did notice is that both of my clay golems have quit and found better jobs. No idea where they went. I did find the wood golem that was here. He was hanging out downstairs in the bottom floor. But the tallow golems, rather, not the clay golems, the tallow golems, both of those guys are just now gone. So I'm not sure what's up with that. We'll just make some more and be done with it, I guess. Not a big deal. I don't have my goggles of revealing right now. I don't even know where they are. They're downstairs, that's right. I did find my jetpack. The quick-eyed among you would have seen it in one of those miscellaneous chests downstairs when last time I looked. But I did find it, so it's all good. So today what we're going to do is we're going to make a Christmas tree stand. And that is, one last thing we're going to need is this. Believe that's all we need. So we've got this here. That goes up top. Nope, we will need dirt. Of course, there's always one more thing that we need. Okay. We've got dirt, we've got a couple of pieces of wood, and a couple of red wool. Not red dye, red wool. There we go. And Christmas tree stand. So what you do with this is you go set it down somewhere and hit it with a piece of bone meal. So let's do this outside because it's going to create a three tall tree with the stand as four, so that's not even going to fit in my house, so we'll have to put it out here. But put the tree stand down, hit it with the bone meal, and voila. Excellent. Nice little happy tree. Whoa. All right. So we're still going to do the big one. I still haven't given up on that project. I am going to be working on this. We've got a couple of weeks. But in the meantime, we're going to decorate up a little tree and have some fun with it. So the next thing that we're going to do is a wreath. Going to put a couple of reeds up and I don't even know where, but we'll find a place for them. I'm going to put lights up right there, so let's see, a wreath, we'll just do this room and we'll put it right there. Excellent. And we'll probably put lights all around here. So what I will do is put the other wreath right there. Pretty cool. And these should just, yeah, these just knock down. You can put them up, replace them, wherever you like. Alright. Next up is we are going to need some string. And we're going to do three of these. One for myself, one for Mr. Garibaldi, and one for Giles. So this is going to be the stocking. Oh, and these don't stack, do they? Nope, they sure don't. Okay, that's all right. Now where can we put these? I really don't have a lot of good wall space for this. We don't have, well, let's see. We can put them right here. This will work. Oh, we can't put them on the thing. Let's, let me go, I will be right back. I will find something to put here that we can set these things on. Okay. Gonna make a little artificial hearth here. That's not good. What was the thing that I could use to, yeah, that's right, my, you can use the crescent wrench from Omni Tools, if you can find one. Here we go. You can use this to reorient the wood. See? Just like that. So, very cool. And three stockings. Excellent. I like that. I like the way that turned out. So yeah, this is the only thing resembling a chimney that we have, and I hope Santa doesn't come down this one, because he's going to get turned into cooked Santa plus Santa nuggets. Alright. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, isn't it? Alright, next thing we're going to do is make some Christmas lights. We're going to do these, make a stack of 8. And they're very simple. A little bit of redstone, a little bit of glass, and dye. And we get Christmas lights. Oop, and Christmas lights. There we go. Cool. So now you can just place these. Let's see, we're going to put... That's what we can do. This is what we'll do. We'll put the switch up here. Okay. So we've got the switch. We've got the switch powering this block. And I think that's all we'll need. So hopefully, anyway. So then we have... We're just going to put these down. Yeah, there we go. And I might have to make some more. But I don't know how far these are going to power. It looks like they're powering pretty much all the entire strand. So that's excellent. And then we'll put some more over here. Cool. So now I'll power these in just a minute. And we're going to put the rest of them over here. This will turn out just perfectly. Excellent. So now we've got two more strands to light up. And I'll light those up in a little bit. Alright, so we've got our Christmas tree down there, so what we need is some ornaments and a topper and a star. So let's go ahead and do the star. There we go. We'll put this down in just a bit. Next we've got the ornaments, which are the glowstone and glass. And die. So we're just going to make 4 of these, I believe. Running out of inventory very quickly. Cool. Alright, let's go decorate the tree. Okay, we are back, and it looks like, I don't know, I can't tell if the, it looks like the textures for these might be off a little bit on some of them, but it does place them on, yeah, it's interesting. It seems like it places them in different locations based on the layer of the tree, because all these are down. But see, these two are up at regular height, so I'm not sure exactly what's going on with that. It's some kind of random thing. But this should be fixed relatively soon. So now all we need to do is get up here I put down our topper. Awesome. Now, I'm not sure if you can light this up or not. Not sure how that's going to work. So let's actually try that, because there is glowstone on them. One would think they would just light up normally, but perhaps not. Would not expect this to work because it's not using redstone. But we're going to try it anyway. Oh, can't put that there. Let's see. That was directly under one of those. Well, doesn't look like this lights up at all. And I don't have... Yep, there's no way to place the... That would be kind of weird to see the lever on top of that anyway. But, cool. Well, we have our tree. And perhaps we'll figure out how to light that up. But there it is. So I will probably be using some of those in my larger tree, along with the lights and the Zycorium blocks over here, which I have plenty of now. Good grief. I probably need to clear some of this out so we can put more in there. Okay, the next thing we're going to craft is some sugar, some candy canes, rather. You can see I've made some there. This sulfur goo works as a dye for wool, but it does not work, thankfully, for candy canes. So we just need some red dye and 3 sugar, just like that. These are not placeable that I have seen. We may be able to hang them on the tree, though. That's worth looking at. Oh, that would be cool if we could put these on the tree. But it doesn't look like we can. Oh my. The cold weather has completely frozen the water in my farm here. Hopefully there aren't any block updates, and we'll just leave that for when ChristmasCraft is uninstalled and everything will be safe there. We're jumping around trying to increase some of our hunger. There we go. Oh, you can't eat these. Awesome. Okay, for this next one, I just happen to have a bucket of milk. Because we'll need this we're going to make some hot cocoa. Now, I did want to show you guys that there's a new... well, not a new one, but another aspect in Thaumcraft is Sano. And it doesn't seem to make anything yet, but there's interesting thing here. It heals, repairs, and makes sound. So that's very, very strange. We'll have to get a cow and maybe a milking machine and get some liquid milk or something and be able to use that. Maybe it'll be potions. I'm not sure. Some kind of healing thing. But... very simple. You put the cocoa beans, you put the milk, you get chocolate milk. And you don't get your bucket back, but that's okay. And now the cool thing we can do here is stick it in the furnace. And my little helper put it in the chest over here, so now we've got hot cocoa. I mean, how cool is that? You're sitting in front of the fire, talking to the blaze in there. You got your stockings, you got your lights. This does look pretty awesome, doesn't it? All we need now is for the biomes to change so it'll snow all over the place here. And it doesn't because we're in the rainforest here, and out there's beach and ocean, and it just rains. So, we're not in a very good location for that. We've got a little bit of regular snow up here and just the corner of the house, really, just a couple of bits. It's, I wish it would just snow everywhere, but it doesn't. The rest of the recipes are, you can make gingerbread cookies and fruitcake and stuff like that. But they come from you have to have Christmas spices for that, which comes from the author calls a semi-rare friendly mob called Creeper Claws. And we haven't really been exploring, so we haven't found any of those. But if we do, we get some spices, we'll make something out of it, probably make the fruitcake, and just leave it sitting, you know, all year like everybody does. But those are, yeah, see, you can make eggnog with this hot cocoa, or actually, no, it's uses another bucket of milk, and an egg and the Christmas spices to make eggnog. So, we don't have the stuff for that, so this is as far as it's going to go. But, this is all very cool stuff. Happy Christmas craft. Probably make some more candy canes. And maybe get as many of those as I can. We'll make some more lights and stuff. Make some more of the Christmas lights and the ornaments. And you can probably put the lights on the tree. That would be kind of tricky to power it, but you might be able to do that. Might be able to use some red wire to hide a wire going up the thing to power the lights. But we will be back with some regular Minecraft in just a little bit. Okay. We have pretty much completed Christmas decorations here. I put some levers up and around, and what we're going to do now is head over to the Nether, because my magmatic engine needs a little bit of work. Hello. Going inside. And you can see here, it blew out one of my gold tubes here, or my gold pipes here. It ran too long, and everything filled up. But you can see here, there's plenty of buckets in here. So Maya, we'll go check out the tank in a minute. But this will have to be fixed before it can be used again. So there we go. You just hit it with a wrench, and then it starts working again. And I don't have. Put all of my levers up before I came out here, even though I needed one. There we go. So now it's shut off. I don't have to move it. So it'll run on its own without needing a signal. But we don't need to pump any more lava right now, and we can't because there's no power going anywhere. So we're going to turn it off like that and leave it. So let's go check out the other half of that setup. Yay. I love Christmas time. It's even better when you can have Christmas in the games that you play. That's just too cool. Alright, so what I did, what I did here was I connected this biogas engine to the tank. Just because I was always coming over here and filling it up, and it just wasn't working right. But we are full here. 5,400 buckets of lava, so this will power our biogas engines forever. And I was doing some experiments, so I went ahead and filled up this one and that one with the lava, so we just don't have to worry about it ever, really. But this one is good to go for the rest of eternity. And let's see, we've got lava in there still. Darn. So yeah, we could probably take 7 or 8 more buckets out of here and still be full from what all's in the system here. And I need another lever to knock that down because I don't need that running. So the next thing we're going to do, probably next episode, will be to automate this. And we may even use a BC gate to have this engine turn off when there's no work needed, like when it runs out of saplings or fertilizer. So we'll probably do something like that. And we'll use the assembly table in the workshop. And I'll try to remember the recipes for that and look all that stuff up before I actually do it. Because I definitely have not messed with any of that since it was implemented. And it's been in the game for a while. And I just haven't made any BC gates really at all. But we'll get that going. We've still got some creosote. I should bring some down someday and make a little bit more creosote oil. I still have to make some aqueous accumulators and replace the pump that we took out of this system. So actually, let's go do that right now. We'll go make an aqueous accumulator or two. Why is that not working sometimes? Can't tell if that's server lag or if that's just, I don't even know. That's right, Mr. Garibaldi. Okay. No. Aqueous accumulator. Okay, so we need two machine frames, two pneumatic servos, some tin, and a couple of buckets. Alright, we'll do the pneumatic servos first. That's a little bit of iron. And I don't have enough. We'll need to get a couple of these. So I'll be back when I have enough, when I have all the ingredients, and then we'll put it together on camera. Okay, we're back, and we're about to make all the stuff that we need for this, for a couple of these aqueous accumulators. So the first thing up is, that's still messed up, but that's okay. We get the gist of it. That goes not there. What's going on here? I see what I'm doing. Okay, we're back. We've got everything we need, and we're going to make a couple of these. So these are pneumatic servos used in the aqueous accumulator. So now we've got two of those. We're going to make a couple of machine frames. Take the gold out of there. Okay, so we've got the machine frames. We've got the pneumatic servos. We've got the tin, glass, and a couple of buckets. Alright, easy enough. These things are pretty cheap. So what we will need, let me go get some... You know what, we've actually got pipes down there. So let's just head right on down and throw these down in the water and get them all hooked up. So we can put one right there. And you can see it filling up. And the configuration, the top. Okay, so that's just going to... There is no other extra configuration for that. It just outputs on all sides. And we'll need... Let's see, that is... Looks like cobblestone. So we'll need a few more of these. And... Let me get rid of this. So we'll just put that right there. That works. And... Yeah, that's good enough. Break that down. That needs to go over to that side anyway. So yeah, we've got a couple extra connections there, but that's fine. And that should provide enough water to keep up with the pump that we had there. So that's perfect. All right, so now we shouldn't have to worry about this anymore. We should have all the water that we'll ever need. Excellent. Let me put these cobblestone things back up here. Cool. All right, I think that's going to be about it for this episode. We are going to get to that, I promise. This tree is pretty cool, though. Hello! Pretty cool indeed. So yeah, we'll put down a skirt. Do I have my... I don't have my red wool anymore. That's okay. We'll do that off camera and have it ready for next time. So thanks for watching, guys. Really appreciate it. ChristmasCraft comes to ForgeCraft. It's very cool. And it really does make all the difference in the world. Just makes everything so festive. Very cool. And let me get rid of the rest of these torches while I'm thinking about it. And I think that's it. Cool. Yeah, the Minecraft lighting system could really use a boost, a change, something, because having to put torches down all over the place just to keep mobs from spawning is pretty ridiculous. But up here, anyway, we've got plenty of candles, we've got all kinds of stuff, and all kinds of lights. And I think these give off lights, too. Or these give off light. Maybe not. Maybe they just the texture just lights up. I'm not sure. It's hard to tell right now, but we'll see. We'll let it get dark, and I'll do that experiment, and let y'all know what happens with it. And we may be able to turn these off as well. Maybe not. We'll figure it out, and we'll see if these actually give off any light or not. Okay, so one more thing that I wanted to mention. A friend of mine is also doing YouTube videos, and you probably, if you've watched my MechWarrior Online videos, you've probably seen him, or heard him anyway, seen and heard him. His name is Redlore Fidelius, and he's doing his own MechWarrior videos. He's also got a series on a game called Crashtastic, which is a physics game, and you put together cars and vehicles and other things and strap rockets to them, and you've got a little crash dummy that you can put in there. And the objective of the game is to complete challenges. They give you challenges like make the cart move 100 meters in a certain direction, or go through a gate, or I guess, you know, do a full 360 barrel roll in the air, or, you know, whatever, stuff like that. And you've got to do that and keep the cart in one piece, or keep your creation in one piece. So it's a very, very cool little physics game, so go check that out. He's also got, if you're inclined to run Minecraft on Linux, he's doing a series on how to install and configure Minecraft for Linux. And that includes the FTP pack. And this guy knows what he's talking about. I don't know if he how much he's told about himself, but go watch the videos. Maybe he explains how he knows so much about it. But it's just a YouTube, HTTP, you know, whatever, youtube.com/redlorefidelius, just like that. It doesn't fit on the sign, or I would have put the whole thing up. But go check him out, because he's got some very cool videos, and he deserves more subscriptions, and he deserves more viewers than he's got right now. That's right, Mr. Garibaldi. Mr. Garibaldi likes Redlore Fidelius. So should you. In the meantime, thanks for watching, guys. I really appreciate it, and we will talk to y'all next time. Bye-bye.